Hello everyone and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain and from this video we will be starting our complete new journey on an amazing course of web scrapping. So guys, in this whole course we will be learning what is web scrapping, with what all Python libraries we can do web scrapping. There are many projects that we will be covering throughout this course. So first of all, if I'm talking about web scrapping, let's first understand that what is web scrapping, what are its applications, where this web scrapping is used, what are the packages that a person can get once they learn web scrapping. So first of all, we will be talking about web scrapping, that what is web scrapping. So web scrapping is nothing but when on websites you have a huge amount of data. So you have seen many websites, for example, you have seen the website of Amazon or Flipkart or any other e-commerce website or any normal website where we have the stock market data or any website which has, different kinds of data. And if you want to extract that data, for that we use web scrapping. So basically what happens over here is that from our websites we extract the HTML. Through that HTML we extract the data. If I'll explain you in the simple terms, we have a website, for example we have Amazon's website, or if we have Flipkart's website, from that by using our web scrapping software. Now what is this web scrapping software over here is, for example, if we are using Python, in Python we have different libraries with the help of which we can scrap the data. For example, we have Beautiful Soup, we have Selenium, then we have a framework called as Scrappy. So there are different libraries with the help of which we can scrap the data. In this course we will be learning about Beautiful Soup and Selenium. So we will be working on how we can work with the Beautiful Soup, how we can extract the data with the help of Beautiful Soup, and how we can extract the data with the help of Selenium. And then we can store this data inside anything. So if you want to store it in a database, you can store it in a database. If you want to store it in an Excel file, in JSON, or in a CSV file, then you can store it in that as well. So basically the next question over here comes is that what is the use of this data? So once we have extracted this data, we can do multiple things out of it. For example, we can use it in the terms of machine learning and data science, that if you want to make any analysis from the data, or suppose if you're creating your own website and if for that you need some data from the other website, in that case you can use that data. Or suppose if there is a sale on any website and if you extract all the data and then with the help of filter function you can see that on which product there is the maximum sale and you can directly go to that product. For example, I'll just give you an idea that if we have a website of Amazon and I want to extract mobiles under 50,000, for that how I will be doing it, I will not be showing you this practically in this video. Later we will be learning this as well, but how we can extract this data is very simple. That here you can open your browser, link it right, Amazon e-commerce company, click on the first link here. In the search option you can write mobiles under 50,000. And you will get this data over here. Now if I copy this data, suppose you will say that okay, you can just directly copy paste this data, no? Like you can just, copy this data, create a new Excel, paste this data. How long does this will be? Because right now we have almost 20 mobiles on this page and then we have many pages here. So to extract all this data, we can use our web scrapping tool called as Beautiful Soup or Selenium. So I'll just show you that I have extracted this data inside Excel over here, where I have so much of data, which includes the name of the mobile phone, the price and the description. And also you can decide that what all data you want to copy. So we have name, we have price, we have description. So this is just to give you an idea that how you will be extracting data, like how you will be getting the data. So extracting procedure, we will be learning that throughout our course, that how we will be extracting it, but how the data will look like and how we can later use it as well. Basically, after extraction, how does the data looks like? We will be seeing that right now. So this is how the data looks like. And if I go to the browser, this is my website. Now not only from our e-commerce website, but if it is a stock market website as well, you can scrap the data from a stock market website as well. Let it be any kind of website, you can scrap the data. Also, what are its applications? So if I talk about its applications, then there are many applications of web scrapping it has. And if I talk about the top industries, we have retail and manufacturing industry, in which we can use the web scrapping, financial research, data science. So as I told you, in the data science also we can use it, like if you you can extract a lot of data from a website. And if you want to make any analysis, any prediction, or if you want to work on data for that, you can use it in data science as well, in marketing and sales, in academic journalism, real estate, and in the stock market data as well, web scraping is used. So this was about web scraping, and if I talk about its scope in future, it has huge scope, because every now and then a new website is created, and for the new website we need the data, and from where we will get the data? With the help of web scraping, with the help of data mining, we can get this data. If I talk about the package or salary, in India the average salary of a data miner or a web scraper is 30,000, and if I talk about the package, it starts from 3 lakhs and it goes up to 10 lakhs. So I hope, guys, that after this video, it is clear to you that what is web scraping, what are its scopes, how it can be done, how does it looks like after we have scrapped the data from a website, what are all its applications, and what are the packages here. So I hope you guys have no doubts in the questions from this video. In our next session, we will be talking about the setup and the installations. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.